this music that we've been working on for months and some of it years for us to finally play it for everyone. And it's also the first student woodwind quintet at Winthrop in multiple years since I've been here, so it's good to do that. So the piece that we just played is called Umoja by Valerie Coleman. This is what Valerie Coleman is, this is what she has on their website for like program notes for Umoja. Umoja is the Swahili word for unity and is the first day in seven in the African American celebration of Kwanzaa. The original composition calls for unity through the tradition of call and response and was first meant to be a simple family sing-along for Kwanzaa, as it was added to the woodwind quintet repertoire for the Imani Winds, a woodwind quintet that was created and founded by Coleman, which they're a really good group, by the way, check them out, and it soon became a signature piece of the ensemble. So that was Umoja. Next, we're going to play a piece called the Roaring Fork Woodwind Quintet by Eric Awazin. Roaring Fork was based on Eric Awazin's trip to Aspen in Colorado. The Roaring Fork is a river valley in Aspen. And he hadn't been east of Detroit in his first 40 years of life, so seeing the mountains was breathtaking to him, and he made him want to write music about it. So the first movement is the Whitewater Rapids. It's all about the energy and fast and that one. The second movement, the Columbines, it's all about the flowers that he sees in the mountains, in the middle of everything else. They're beautiful, but sometimes mysterious as to why they're there. And the third movement is the Buckskin Pass. It's all about being at the top of the mountain and seeing all the variety and contrast between the dramatic other mountains in the area and also the vibrant colors of the pastures. So there's lots of different moods in that one. And as this is a three-movement piece, please hold your applause until the end of the third one. We hope you enjoy Eric Awazin's Roaring Fork. Thank you.
Thank you.
So much for coming out to hear us. The last item on our program is Aires Tropicalis by Paquita de Rivera. He was born and raised in Havana, Cuba, where his father taught him to appreciate music. And he ended up going to the Havana Conservatory of Music to study. So it would make sense that throughout this piece there are Cuban influences. Two of these movements, the son and the habanera, are Cuban dance forms. Additionally, the sixth movement is inspired by a composer of Cuban descent. Furthermore, in the style of Paquito's fusing of Latin, jazz, and classical traditions, he also included Venezuelan waltz in this piece. He included African folk influences in addition to Spanish influences. So again, thank you very much for coming out, and please enjoy Aires Tropicalis.
Thank you. Thank you. The third.